In this video, we are going to look at some example datasets that might need some transformation before we can make a regression model using them. To understand this, we are going to examine the income dataset example that we saw in the previous video. If you recall, we made a regression model in the last video that predicted the number of male workers based on the number of female workers. The dataset initially had 558 rows, and it was cut down to 83 rows since we did not want to include rows with very low or high values. So this time, without removing any of the rows, let's straight away make a scatter plot with number of female workers on the x-axis and number of male workers on the y-axis. As you can see, there's a single point that is standing out as an outlier. If you examine the data, you would see that this point is referring to the first row, that is summing up the rest of the data in a single row that is named all occupations. I would therefore delete the first row and remake the scatter plot. Even now, you can see most of the points in the plot are bunched up in the lower left corner. The remaining points where there are relatively higher number of male and female workers are spread out in other regions of the plot. These group of points in the lower left corner suggest that most of the occupations have range-bound number of male and female workers, and remaining occupations have relatively higher number of male and female workers. You can confirm this finding by examining the value of mean, median, and outliers for the two columns M workers and F workers. When you will make the regression line using this data, these points that are spread across the graph would pull the regression line towards them. If you go through the summary of the regression model in mode 1 and see the value of R square, you can see that the model has only managed to reduce the total error in M worker by roughly 37%. One of the reasons for low value of R square is the large difference in values for each of the variables in the model. To resolve such issues, the two variables in the data are needed to be transformed before they can be used for making the regression model. I started with this example because I want you to understand that large differences in values within a variable can affect the regression model. Now we will go through the entire process of examining the income dataset and transforming it. We will use two other columns in the income data example, namely male weekly income and female weekly income. First off, we are going to look at two histograms. One would show the frequency distribution of male weekly income, and the other would display the frequency distribution of female weekly income. To display these two histograms in the same output, I am going to use the PAR function, which can be remembered as the short form for parameter. If you don't use the parameter function, R would by default produce one graph corresponding to the last line of code. The graph would of course cover the entire output area. Using the parameter function, we can ask R to display subsequent graphs in the same output window. We are going to use parameter function with mfrow argument to achieve this. MFRow argument is a way of dividing the output region into number of rows and columns. So when we are setting the MFRow argument to 1, 2, we are dividing the output region into one row and two columns. This would of course create space for two graphs. In the same manner, by setting the MFRow argument to 2, 2, we are dividing the output region to two rows and two columns. This would create space for a total of four graphs. To go back to the default way of displaying graph, you can set the MFRow argument to 1, 1, which would create space for a single graph. Now let's go back to the output of the histogram function for the two variables. Histogram displays the number of times different range of values are appearing in a variable on the y-axis. The range are automatically created by the histogram function and display on the x-axis. Each of these bars represent a range of values in a variable. For instance, let's say this bar represents all the values in the variable between 500 and 550, and this bar denotes all the values in the variable between 550 and 1000, and so on. If you recall the properties of normal distribution, the frequency should be highest for the middle bars. And on the right and left part of the histogram, the frequency for each range should ideally get lower and lower and eventually disappear. If the histogram made from the variable is not showing these properties of normally distributed data, we should consider making some transformations to the variable. Just to recall, we have created these two histograms using shortlisted copy of income data that contains occupation, male weekly income, and female weekly income. We have named this data frame income data 2. Do remember that earlier in the video, we have deleted the first row because it summarizes the rest of the data in a single row under the title All Occupation. We will once again go back to the output of the histogram function for the two variables male weekly income and female weekly income. As you can see, most of the workers, whether male or female, have similar weekly income in the $500 to $1,000 range. It is evident from the initial tall bars. However, there are industries that give relatively lower or higher income to workers, which is visible from the shorter bars in the two graphs. For instance, you can see certain industries are giving a weekly income in the $2,500 range, which is 5 times compared to the most common range of $500 to $1,000. One of the reasons for such differences in value could be incorrect data. But it is a general knowledge that some of the industries pay higher salary to qualified workers with specialized skills, and this sort of variation is possible. So assuming that the values are correct, we need some way to reduce the difference between the lowest and the highest range of values. Just to reiterate, those values that are relatively higher or lower than the most common range of values can pull the regression line towards them, and this would result in wrong prediction of the response variable. Let's look at another way for figuring out whether the variables used in the model are needed to be modified or not. For this, we can compare the output of the histogram function with a bell. As per the property of normally distributed data, variables that are used for making the model are needed to have a bell-shaped frequency. The histograms does not have to resemble a bell in the exact manner, but some degree of resemblance is necessary. The histogram graphs that we have created using male weekly income and female weekly income are not similar to the bell shape, as most of the data is bunched up on the left side. This comparison with the bell shape also points that both the variables should be ideally modified before we use them for making the model. So based on what we have learned in this video, we want to achieve two things from the variables in the model. First is that our scatter plot should not have a set of points that are too much distant from the rest. Second is that the histogram for the predictor and response variable that are used in the model should resemble the shape of a bell. We will stop this video here. From the next video onwards, we will start looking at different methods of transforming the data, beginning with the log transformation.